Hi guys, and welcome to C++ tutorial of payroll management system developed using C++ Builder. So let's enter some other new data. You see all of these data in here, right here. Just click on that tab and there they are. And click on payroll system. If you click on the database, every single information we have in here is also saved straight onto the database, and it's coming up now. There we go. Check out the table there. So what I'm going to do is close that and let's enter new data in here. So we come right here, click on plus. There, every single information is gone. Enter the candidate details and the name. Let's say the name is Tony Allen. And Tony Allen lives in Island, let's say Allen Lane. Number 3 Allen Lane. Let's put an S there. And gender is male. Let's say is a medic, and postcode. Okay, position. Oh, department as a medic, and let's say it is a doctor. And here, there, and here, that is his wages. Overtime, nope. And that's it. So all we then need to do is to state the tax period. Let's say this is the pay. Let's go for the third month. Okay, somewhere there. And here, tax period 3. Payroll name. We can just call that medic as well. Medical. NI number, and that's the other code and tax code there. So all we need to do is to come right here and just click on total. There we go, all of the necessary information is officially added. Okay, if we come in here now, we should be able to see the details of Tony Allen right there. Look at that. Okay, let's go back in here, and you can just tap. Oh, now let's check if we have the details of Tony Allen on the database. So let's double click on the database, and that's coming up. Double click on the table right there. That's the details of Tony Allen, and I'll see you guys with the full tutorial shortly. Hi and welcome to payroll management system developed using C++ and using the C++ builder by Embarcado. I'm going to start by going to file here, and I'm going to select new. Let's select Windows VCL application. Just click on that, and right there the development environment is ready. Now, let's increase this form size. I'm going to come right here where we have form height. Let's come in here. I'm going to make that 720. And right underneath here where we have width, I'm going to make that 1386. Right. And let's give it a name. You see this caption? I'm going to change that to payroll management system. There, that is changed right up here. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come right here and I'll just type in cpage controller, or control is called. And just paste that right there. have my page control. I'm going to kind of like extend it all the way to the right and below as well. There. Now let's bring it right down. Okay. But that's one thing. Let's come in here. I'm going to drag this down because I intend to add title up there. And right here, I'm going to go back to the palette again. Let's type in panel. Yep. Just add the panel there. Let's drag it that much. And this very panel, I'm going to come in here to change the caption. Just enter payroll management system in there. And let's change the font size of that. Let's come right down here, font there. Let's make it a little bit readable, bold and readable. Let's see, I'm going to make that 52. That seems to be a little bit too big. All right, so drag this down anyway. Okay, now the next thing we want to do is, you see this my page control. I intend to add extra page to it. Right click on it and select add new. That's the first one. Right click again and add another one. That is the second one. Okay, so for the very first one, let's change the caption of that to maybe payroll system, role system. And the other one, so I'm just going to call it payroll database. So we store all our information there. When you select it, make sure you select the interface and scroll right down or up there and look for the caption. So I'm going to enter payroll details or database. There we go, all of the information that we will have in here will be stored in here. That's good. So now let's do one more thing. I'm going to get hold of this very panel. Let's come in here, just enter T panel there and just draw it right here. You see this teeth panel that I've just added? I'm going to change the color to maybe something silver. Yeah, we can change it to silver, that's fine. Let's come right up here. Yeah, I can see the silver, that's it there, and get rid of the text content in there. Okay, so just drag it that much. I just want to give it a bit of contrast. There we go, and bring it up the way down. Okay, all right, so let's drag this down a little bit and bring it down a little bit more. Okay, so if I run it now, let's just run and see how that's gonna look like. There, that is how it's looking now. Okay, not too bad. Okay, now I'm going to do one thing, exit out. I'm now going to then add another panel here. Let's come in here, grab a panel, T panel, grab that and just draw it right here. There we go. Now this panel that I have up here, let's change the back color. So let's go straight to color, get rid of the text content and come right here. Let's see if we can get anything that will be a little bit lighter than silver. Let's go for, no, that is a bit, yeah, but in face works much better. And bring this here. Okay, it's looking good. Now I can just copy and paste. So copy that. Let's see, we have enough room. Copy and paste. We have two, and I'm going to need one underneath here. Paste again, cut it off, paste it right here. Okay then, bring it down right down here and take it right down. Okay then. Now, let's do one thing because I may kind of like run out of room, but let's copy this first. Copy this and paste it right here. This is going to be a very huge tutorial, so I suppose you guys are ready. So bring this all the way down here. Somewhere there. Now copy it again. Click on the plane, paste. There. Okay, looking good so far. I'm going to run it. Let's just run and see how it's looking. Alright, this is how it's looking. It's coming up gradually. I like that. I'm going to do one thing. Let's take this up a little bit. And yeah. Now drag this all the way. All the way down here. That is good. Yeah, that is fine. Maybe take this up a little bit more. Yeah, something like that. Okay. And let's see. So I'm just designing as I go along. So I may end up changing one or two things. But for now, let's settle for this. Okay, let's go to the design right here. Sorry, the payroll data. The payroll data. Maybe we should copy this. Yeah, I'm gonna copy this. Copy and paste it right in here. There we go. That is fine. So right inside the payroll data, we will then enter a data preview. Bring this here. For those of you, if you understand how to design an interface, you can just skip this part of it. So I'm gonna come in here now. Let's look for, we look for data grid view there. There we go. So click on that and I'm gonna put it right here. That is it. Just drag. Okay, that's looking good. All right. Now let's go back to the main page of this application, and right here I'm going to enter as follows. I need a label. Come right here. Let's say TL. Now should give me a label. Paste that here. And what else do I need? I'm going to need TDBE. Okay, paste that right here. Let's move that up here. There. Before I start all of this, let me do one thing. I better save this application because it's getting bigger now. Let's go to File, Save. Just call it pay. Now I'm gonna call it CPP payroll management system. Okay, let's select the folder. I have a folder there already. That's the folder. Okay. So I'm going to, yeah, let's save that in there. Let's copy this, save, and I'm going to save the whole project as well. There, save that. And so that's, no, let's just put an S in front of it. Save and save again, double S, there. Okay, that is fine. Now, if you notice, I seems to have, I've already added my database that I intend to use right in there. Let me show it to you guys now. Let's come right in here, and that is it. Payroll system, that is the database I intend to use. Okay, I've just double click on the databases and access database. There's nothing in the table. There's nothing on the table, that is it right there. And if you right click, you can go to the design view. That is it, that's just my table. Every single data type is just short text, okay? The choice is yours, whatever you want to, how you want to design it. In total, there's 25 records there. Or 25 fields, I mean. So I'm gonna close that. We'll come back to this later on, so minimize that. Now let's continue with this. Okay, we need to increase the font size of this, move that up and come right here, font. Let's see, where's font? Increase the font size to something a little bit readable, maybe about 22. There we go. That seems too big, so let's reduce it a little bit more. I'm gonna make it 18. All right, and just drag it that much. And this is going to be my like employer ID, so our employee ID. I mean, come straight to the caption and just change that to employee ID. ID. There we go. And this, the text box is going to be known as, let's select that. It's a database text box, so I'm going to just change that to DBE employee ID. Okay, then. Yeah, that'll do. Right, so let's copy that. Control C, copy, paste. We have two. Now I'm gonna paste another one. Three, paste again. We have four, and add one more. We have five. There. Okay, so let's change these details here. So this one is going to be, let's change that to full name. Let's come straight to the caption right there. There. So this is going to be full name. And here, let's change this to address. Right, and here that is going to be address. Now I'm going to change this one to maybe postcode. Yeah, let's go for that. We change that to postcode. And this is going to be postcode. Let's come straight to the name here. DBE postcode. There we go. Now let's do one thing. You see this postcode? I'm going to reduce that and copy this. Copy the two of them. Control C and paste. And this is going to be gender. Bring this here. And as for this, I'm going to delete this. Let's come in here and get CDBE combo box. Let's paste that in here. The combo box, let's change the data in there. Now let's change the font to 18. There we go. That's good. And change the data in here to, where is gender? So that would be gender. Now, this combo box is going to be known as DBC gender. There. All right, looking good so far. Now that that is done, this one. Okay, let's change this other one to, I'm going to delete this and just copy this other one here, or let's see, yeah, delete it and copy all of this here, Control C, and let's paste that in here, bring it down, and then change this. I want to change that to position and department. Yeah, position okay, that's the position. So let's change this one to DBE position, and this is going to be department. Let's come in here, where is it? Right here, no, up here, caption. Department, yeah, that will do. All right then. Okay, and this will become department. Let's just drag this that much and repeat the same thing for this one. Okay, this will be department. All right, now all of these other ones, let's just drag them that much. I'll repeat the same thing for this other one. Right, and this one as well. That's good. So bring it down. Now let's take care of the wages. The case of wages, let's come in here, we should be able to fit 5 of those in here. Let's see, I'm gonna copy these ones, Control C and paste. There we go. One more here, copy, no, let's copy these ones, copy and paste it right underneath here. Yeah, that's good. And right below it, I'm going to get rid of this one, I don't need this one. Copy this, copy and paste it right here. We enhance that later on. Right below it, I'm going to enter, let's copy all of this, copy and paste it right here. Then we change the data around, paste another one here. Now delete this. Okay, so this one here, I'm going to change that to net pay. And in the text box, this one will be known as net pay. Let's come in here and change the default name. Yeah, net pay. And this is going to be known as default. No, that will be known as deduction. Let's come right here. Deduction, changes to deduction. Right here, this is going to be known as gross pay. Let's come right up here, gross, changes to gross pay. Where's the variable name? Right here. There we go. Right, looking good so far. So I'm going to save and let's run it and see how that looks like. Yeah, move that up. Okay, that's how it's looking, guys. It's coming up real good. Now let's do one thing. If you notice, when I run it, the form was kind of like up here or down here. So I'm gonna exit out. Let's select that very form and come right up here. You see where we have a line. I'm gonna set it to top, so that is good. So if I run it now, that should be right at the top. Let's see. You see that? So that's what I want. Good. Now here, let me populate here as well. And here, that is going to be the calculator interface. Or we can make that to have calculator. Yeah, why not? That might take a long time. Okay, let's see. I've made up my mind. Now, right here, I need all of the information for the wages. So first thing first, let's copy something here, copy that, copy this, copy and paste that right here, paste, take it up and drag this that much, put the same thing here. Okay, and this is going to be pay date or pay day, whatever. Date, and this becomes pay date. There we go. And this becomes tax period. Let's come right here. That's tax period. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, and this I'm going to delete that. Let's use combo box for that and paste that right here for the tax period. We can always enter the numbers in there and change the variable name to tax period. There we go, it's coming up pretty good. Okay, I guess you guys get the whole idea. So all I'm just gonna do now is I'm gonna copy this, just paste it right there. So let's just paste this there. We have, let's copy this again, copy, paste, and copy and paste again. We have 5. Copy, paste. Yeah. And we can add 2 more. Copy and paste. There we go, guys. There. Now, I'm going to save, run. Let's see how that's looking. Okay, check that out, guys. It's coming up pretty good. Okay, grab a button. We need a calculator. Yeah, we have one here. I'm also going to need just a T, B, E. No, B. TE, yeah, TE. Text editor, yeah, that's all I need here. Alright, let's change the font size of the both of them to 18 as well. We may have to change the details of this font, I don't know, but let's just put 18 and see. Okay, oh, what about this? 18, drag this here. Now copy this. We have two. Let's increase the size a little bit. Copy and paste. Right. Yeah, almost right. That's fine. That will do. All right. Now we can then copy and just spread it along. Okay, so let's copy this and paste. Copy, paste. Okay, coming up good. And just one more, copy and paste. There we go, guys. Yeah. And all I then need to do is just change the data in here. Come in here, that's going to be 7. We have 8, 9, subtract. We have 6, 5, 4, 1, 2, 3. Division. Multiplication equals. And decimal, then 0. Okay, and here I'm going to call that CE, and here I'm going to call that C. This is going to be backspace and so on. Now, this very one, let's come in here, change the text to 0, and let's get it aligned to the right. There should be something to align here. Align. Right. Okay, let's go straight into Word document and look for a backspace. Now, inside Word document, I'm going to come in here, select insert. You see where we have symbol, click on symbol. And that's the backspace that I want. You will always find that very backspace in Wingings. Where is it? Start with W. Let me just type in W in there. There we go. Right there. And if you scroll right down a little bit, you should be able to get the sign that I'm looking for, or the symbol that I'm looking for. That is it right there. Insert. Okay, insert. And I'm also going to insert plus minus. Close that. Copy the backspace and paste it right in here. Where is the caption? Paste. Now all we have is just a dot. Let's scroll right down. We need to change the font type. Come down here, just click on that, type in W Wingings. There we go. That takes care of that. In the case of plus minus, I think we don't need to change anything in there. So let's go straight to the caption. Caption, paste that in there, plus minus. There we go. That is it. So I'm going to save that and click on run. Right there, guys, look at the interface coming up very good. Now you see here, I'm just going to add Navigator in there. So close that. Let's go right down. You see here, come right here, let's say TDB. I think it's a B, E, Nav. No, there we go. That's it, Navigator. And just drag it here. That is it. That's my Navigator right there. Okay, so this other one, we just extended that much. We're gonna make it look a bit more presentable. And this as well, drag it like that. And this other one, just drag it. Let's bring it that way. Right, and I think I'm going to call that the end of the first part of this tutorial. It's pretty long though, but that's alright. There we go, guys. So that will be the end of the first part of this tutorial, and I'll see you guys shortly. Bye for now.